Madame Giry's daughter, promising dancer, Monsieur Andre, most promising.
You, Christine Daggy.
Concentrate, Ben. Christine, what's the matter?
Daggy! Curious name!
Sweet emulation to the violinist. His daughter, I believe, always has her head in a cloud, I'm afraid.
Yeah.
there.
This monsieur does not have me. As God's my witness, I was not at my post. Please, monsieur, there's no one there. And if there is, well, then it must be her. Ghost!
Good heavens, I have never known such insolence!
Signora, please! These things do happen.
These things do happen? You have been here 5 minutes. What's going on now? See? These things do happen all the time. For the past 3 years, these things do happen. And did you stop them from happening? No! And you are as bad as him. These things to happen? Well, until you stop these things from happening, this thing does not happen! Ubaldo! Andiamo!
Amateurs!
Well, I don't think there's much more I can do to assist you, gentlemen. Good luck.
Monsieur!
If you need me, I shall be in Frankfurt.
La Carlotta will be back!
You think so, monsieur? I have a message, sir, from the opera ghost.
Oh, in heaven, you're all upset!
He merely welcomes you to his opera house. Commands that you continue to leave Box 5MD for his use. And reminds you that his salary is due.
His salary?
Monsieur Lefebvre paid him 20,000 francs a month.
Oh, good God.
Perhaps you can afford more, with the Vicomte de Chagny as your patron.
Madam, I had hoped to have made that announcement myself.
Will the Vicomte be at the performance this evening, monsieur?
Yes, in our box.
Madam, who is the understudy for the role?
There is no understudy, monsieur. The production is new.
Christine Dyer could sing it, sir.
A chorus girl?
She's been taking lessons from a great teacher.
From whom?
I don't know, sir.
Oh, not you as well! Can you believe it? A full house and we have to cancel.
Let her sing for you, monsieur. She has been well taught.
Very well.
From the beginning of the aria, then, mademoiselle.
Imagine me trying
waiting.
Bravo!
Long ago, it seems so long ago, how young and innocent we were. She may not remember me, but I
not a single refund.
Greedy.
Resign.
I think we have made quite a discovery in this diet.
Here we are, Monsieur le Vicomte.
Yes, gentlemen, if you wouldn't mind, this is one visit I should prefer to make unaccompanied.
As you wish, Monsieur.
Thank you.
Well, they appear to have met before.
Christine Daae, where is your red scarf?
Monsieur?
You can't have lost it. Not after all the trouble I took. I was just 14. Soaked to the skin.
Because you had run into the sea to fetch my scarf. Oh, Raoul, so it is you.
Christine. Little Lottie, let her mind wander.
Remember that too.
Little Lottie thought, am I fonder of dolls, or of goblins, of shoes,
or of riddles, of frogs?
Those picnics in the attic, or of chocolates?
Father playing the violin.
As we read to each other dark stories of the north.
No, what I love best, Lottie said, is when I'm asleep in my bed, and the angel of music sings songs in my head.
The angel of music sings songs in my head.
Father said, when I'm in heaven, child, I will send you the angel of music. Well, the father is dead, Raoul, and I have been visited by the angel of music.
Well, there is no doubt of that. But now we go to supper.
No, Raoul. The angel of music is very strange.
I shan't keep you up late.
No.
You must change. I must get my hat. 2 minutes, little Lottie.
Raoul!
Basking in your glory, ignorant fool, this brave young suitor, sharing in my triumph.
Angel, I hear you speak. I listen. Stay by my side. Guide me.
In the mirror, I am there inside.
Angel of music, guide and guardian, grant me your glory. Angel of music, hide no longer, grant me strength.
Come to me, angel of music.
Whose is that voice? Who is that in there?
I am your angel,
Christine,
of music. Come to me, angel,
Christine,
of music.
Christine! Angel.
Thank you.
sing. I have needed you with me to serve me, to sing.
what you wanted to see. Monsieur, you little lying Delilah, you little viper, now you cannot ever be free. Damn you! We must return. Those two fools who run my theatre will be missing you.
Sending care of the ghost by return of post. P.T.O.
No one likes a debtor, so it's better if my orders are obeyed. Who would have the gold to send this? Someone with a puerile brain. These are both signed Eugene.
Who the hell is he?
Oh, produced. It's really not amusing.
He's abusing our position.
In addition, he wants money.
He's a funny sort of spectre.
To expect a large retainer. Nothing plainer. He is clearly quite insane.
Miss Dyer, where is she?
Well, how should we know?
And, sir, I take it that you sent me this note.
What's all this nonsense?
Of course not.
Don't look at us.
She's not with you then.
Of course not.
We're in the dark. Monsieur, don't argue. Isn't this the letter you wrote?
And what is it that we're meant to have wrote? Written?
Do not fear for Miss Dyer. The angel of music has her under his wing. Make no attempt to see her again.
If you didn't write it, who did?
Where is he?
Oh, welcome back!
Precious patron, where is he?
What is it now?
I have no letter, a letter which I rather resent.
And did you send it?
Of course not.
As if he would.
You didn't send it?
Of course not.
What's going on?
You dare to tell me that this is not the letter you sent.
And what is it that I meant to have sent?
Your days at the opera populaire are numbered. Christine Dyer will be singing on your behalf tonight. Be prepared for a great misfortune. You attempt to take her place.
Far too many notes for my taste, and most of them about Christine. Only persons we came to decide to name.
Returned.
In which case, I think our meeting is adjourned.
Where precisely is she now?
I thought it best that she went home. I needed rest.
May I see her?
No, monsieur, she will see no one.
Will she sing?
Here, I have a note.
Let me see it, please.
Gentlemen, I have now sent you several notes of the most amiable nature, detailing how my theater is to be run. You have not followed my instructions. I shall give you one last chance.
Christine Dyer has returned to you, and I am anxious her career should progress in the new production of Il Muto. You will therefore cast her letter as the page boy, and put Miss Dyer in the role of Countess. The role which Miss Dyer plays calls for charm and appeal. The role of the page boy is silent, which makes my casting in a word ideal. I shall watch the performance from my normal seat in box 5, which will be kept empty for me.
Should these commands be ignored, a disaster beyond your imagination will occur. I remain, gentlemen, your obedient servant, O.G.
Christine.
What have I next?
It's not a point of
him.
This is insane.
I will send this the Vicomte Hunter.
Indeed, can you believe this?
Signora!
You are a star.
And always will be.
Signora!
The man is back. I'll take orders.
Miss Dyer will be playing the page boy.
The silent
role.
Carriata would be playing the lead.
You don't deserve her.
It's useless trying to
you.
It's
We need you too.
Would you not rather have your precious little Angelou?
Signora, no! The world was
Madonna, first lady
of the stage, your devotees are on their knees to implore you. Can you bow out when they're shouting your name? Think of how they all adore you. Can you deny us the triumph in store?
Sing every Madonna once more.
Prima Madonna, your song shall live again
into the public.
But there's a public only.
Sitting in box five.
Do you really think that's wise, monsieur?
My dear Andre, there would appear to be no seats available other than box five.
They say that this youth has set my lady's heart aflame.
His lordship sure would die of shock.
His lordship is a laughing stock.
Sure, he is a suspect, our God protector.
Shame, shame, shame.
This grievous lady's bound for these.
Shame, shame, shame.
Nothing like the old opera.
Or the old scenery.
The old singers.
The old audience.
And every seat sold.
Your disguise is perfect.
Hardly a disaster beyond all imagination.
Why? Who can this be?
Gentle wife, admit your loving husband. My love, I am called to England, or fair must leave you with your new maid.
Though I gladly take the maid with me.
Your fool is a leaving.
I suspect my young bride is untrue to me. I shall not move.
What shall I do? I could fail.
Thank you. Summertime, say you need me with you. will find you. Your fears are far behind you.
All I want is freedom, a world with no more night. And you, always beside me, to hold me and to hide me.
Then say you share with me one love, one lifetime. Let me lead you from your solitude. Anywhere you go, let me go too. Christine, that's all I ask of
you. Say you share with me one love, one lifetime. Say the word and I will follow you.
Share each day with me, each night. Each morning,
say you love me.
Oh, I do love me. That's all I Christine.
Good Messiah, I have returned you. opera. Here I bring the finished score. Don Juan triumphant. I advise you to comply. My instructions should be clear. Remember, there are worse things than a shattered chandelier. Your chains are still mine. You will sing for me.
Jury!
Monsieur, don't ask me. I know no more than anyone else.
That's not true. You've seen something, haven't you?
I don't know what I've seen. Please don't ask me,
Jury. All our sex.
Years ago, there was a traveling fair in the city. Tumblers, conjurers, human oddities.
Go on.
And there was, shall never forget him, a man locked in a cage.
In a cage?
A prodigy, monsieur. Scholar, architect, musician.
A composer.
And an inventor, too, monsieur. They boasted he had once built for the Shah of Persia a maze of mirrors.
Who was this man?
Freak of nature, more monster than man.
Deformed.
From birth, it seemed.
My God, Christine.
And then he went missing. He escaped.
Go on.
They never found him. It was said he had died.
But he didn't die, did he?
The world forgot him. But I never can. For in this darkness,
so
I have seen him again. I have said too much, monsieur.
No, wait.
Too much. There have been too many accidents.
Accidents, Madame Jury.
Ludicrous, have you seen the score?
Simply ludicrous.
It's the final straw.
It is ludicrous. Whether you know my guilt.
What a lunacy.
But we did
refuse. Not another chandelier.
Look, my friend, what we have here.
Dear Andre, my orchestrations. We need another first bassoon. Every note overblown, and that third trombone has to go. The man could not be deaf, so he's preferably one who plays in tune.
If him it be to be my opera,
some
or his members must be sacked. If you could find out which has a sense of pitch, wisely though, I've managed to assign a rather minor role to those who cannot act.
Oratory!
What is it now?
It's all the medicine! Oratory!
Signore,
now what's the matter?
Have you seen the size of my butt?
Gentlemen, listen.
It's an insect.
That too is worse.
Doesn't it mean it's an insect?
Please understand.
Signore, signore.
The things I have to do for my art.
If you can call these gibberish at...
Ah, here is our little flower.
Ah, Miss Dying, quite the lady of the hour.
You have secured the largest role in this Don Juan.
Christine dying, she doesn't have the voice.
Signora, please!
Then I take it you're agreeing.
She's behind this.
It appears we have no choice.
She's the one behind this. Christine dying.
How dare you?
I'm a fool.
You evil woman, how dare you?
You don't think I'm lying?
This isn't my fault. I don't want any part of this plot.
Miss Dying, surely.
But why not?
What does she say?
It's your decision, but why not?
She's backing out.
You have a duty.
I cannot sing it, duty or not.
Christine, Christine, you don't have to. They can't make you.
Please, monsieur. Another note.
Oh.
Fondest greetings to you all. A few instructions just before rehearsal starts.
Carlotta must be taught to act, not her normal trick of strutting round the stage. Our Don Juan must lose some weight. It's not healthy in a man of Kionji's age. And my managers must learn that their place is in an office, not the arts.
If pride will let her return to me, her teacher,
your obedient friend.
And angel. I can't. I won't do it.
We have all been blind. And yet the answer is staring us in the face. This could be the chance to ensnare our clever friend.
You're listening, go on.
We shall play his game, perform his work, but remember we hold these. For if Miss Dye sings, he is certain to attend.
We make certain the doors are barred. We make certain of their there.
We make certain they're armed.
The curtain falls, his reign will end.
Madness!
I'm not so sure. Look if it works.
This is madness!
The tide will turn.
Monsieur, believe me, there is no way of turning the tide.
You stick to ballet.
Then help us.
Monsieur, I can't.
Instead of warning us, help us.
I wish I could.
Not make excuses.
Well, could it be that you're on his side?
Jesus, accomplice!
Monsieur, believe me, I intend no ill, but monsieur, be careful, we have seen
him.
We
say a bomb in will.
There's the phrase. Those who turn if you please.
Those who tingle with tamale.
No, nearly, but no.
His way's better. At least he makes it sound like a music.
Signor, would you speak that way in the presence of the composer?
The composer is not here, and if he were...
Can you be certain of that, signora?
So, once again, if you please. Signor Piangi, after 7.
Huh?
5, 6.
I cannot lose your style.
so helpless, yearning for my guidance.
Angel, Father, friend, or phantom, how is it best?
Have you forgotten your
angel, or snake, what endless longings echo in this sky?
Too long you've wandered in winter, far from my far-reaching gaze.
Wildly my mind beats again, she
resist, yet your soul obeys. Take the love music, you divine me, turning from true beauty. Take the love music, do not shun me, angel of music.
Leave her! You have no claim on her, leave her! Your words are wasted, can't you see? She'll never be yours! Christine!
Bravo, monsieur, such spirited words!
What tricks, monsieur?
Let us see, monsieur, how far you dare go!
More deception, more violence!
That's right! That's right, keep walking this way!
You can't win her love by making her your prisoner!
I'm here, monsieur! The angel of death!
Monsieur, I fear you not!
Well, come on, don't stop!
Don't stop!
Don't go! So be it! Now let it be war upon you both!
Instructions?
Sir!
When you hear the whistle, take up your positions. I shall then instruct you to secure the doors. It is essential that all doors are properly secured.
Are we doing the right thing, Andre?
Have you got a better idea?
Sir, be calm, am I to give the order?
Give the order. You, in the pit. Do you have a clear view of this box?
Yes, sir.
Remember, when the time comes, shoot. Only if you have to, but shoot to kill.
How will I know, sir?
You'll know.
Monsieur the Vicomte, are you confident that this will work? Will Miss Daye
see? Yes, don't worry, Fernand.
Andre!
We're in your hands, sir.
My men are now in position, sir.
Go ahead, then.
Are the doors secure?
Secure!
Secure! Secure!
Phantom of the Opera.
Hold your fire.
I hear the Phantom of the Opera. I'm here.
You fool, I said only when the time comes.
But Monsieur le Vicomte.
No buts. For once, Monsieur le Vicomte is right.
Seal my fate tonight. I hate to have to cut the fun short, but the joke's wearing thin. Let the audience in, let my opera begin.
Oh, my God.
I'll serve you, loyal faithful friend, once again a receiver fan.
Your youngest believes in you, by the master, you the man.
When you met, you wore my cloak, she could not have seen your face. She believes she dines with you in her master's but a place. Then she believes you'll scoff and walk, seeing what in the truth is a night. It's late and modesty sucks you mellow with the wine.
I come the home, I use you, I slam the door, I crack of doom.
I shall cry, come hide with me, they're aware of course my room.
Warping has and go but chance.
Here's my hat, my cloak and sword, fantasies ashore. If I do not forget myself and love.
Silence.
here with you. No second thoughts. I've decided. Decided. Past the point of no return. No going back.
thus for blood. Am I now to be prey to your lust for flesh?
That fate which condemns me to wallow in blood has also denied me the joys of the flesh. This face, the infection which poisons our love. This face. Fear and loathing, a mask, my first unfeeling scrap of clothing. Pity comes too late, turn around and face your fate, an eternity of this before your eyes. A guest!
Christine!
Sir, this is indeed an unparalleled delight. I had rather hoped that you would come. And now my wish comes true. You have truly made my night. Free her! Do what you like, only free her! Have you no pity? Your lover makes a passionate plea.
Please, Raoul, it's useless.
I love her. Does that mean nothing? I love her. Show some compassion. The world showed no compassion to me. Christine, Christine, let me see her. Be my guest.
Peter!
my patience. Make your choice.
No.